calm down.
I will not calm down.
You and I are friends, right? But if you ever go behind my back like that again, I will personally take you down.
Back off, Alex. Now, I've known you since you were a low-level operative at the CIA.
Do not play that card with me. You think you're above the law? You are not above the law.
I didn't say I was above the law.
You said just exactly that when you went behind my back with one of my agents for your own personal crusade.
We needed to do something.
Richard, there are channels for that kind of thing.
The hell with your channels. Now, that could have taken weeks, months. Elizabeth could have been killed.
You see, that's what I'm talking about. If the victim was any other American, would you have done the same thing? Yeah, I thought so. Because not everyone has Lionel Wakefield's money. So you tell me this. Why is it that you and your friends get special treatment?
Like you wouldn't have done the same thing for one of your friends or daughters.
Do not turn this around on me, okay? You broke the law.
I saved two lives. You're sore because your toes are getting stepped on.
Richard, stay away from my agents. Period.
Don't go there.
No. This conversation is over, sir.
Sure, Henry knows women, but he also understands guys like me. Every single renovation that he does, he makes sure that the wife sets aside at least one room for the husband. It's a den, a study, the basement, any place that the guy can call his own. And that is crucial to the success of every marriage. I got the garage. Whoa, watch it.
Yeah, right. Down goes Frazier. You break something? Not you.
I need my car. I mean, you gotta
be careful.
You gotta watch your step in a place like this.
That's dirt on my shoes.
Yeah, that's dirt, all right.
And blisters from shoveling.
What are you talking about shoveling?
I was out in the woods and I was digging.
Rick, listen to me, okay? You went outside, you chopped wood to build a fire.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. And dirt on shoes and blister happened that way, okay? And that fire in the fireplace where it didn't start itself.
No. Something is really wrong here.
Okay, fine. So you tell me what happened.
You were in the shower. And I went upstairs to the attic. And this naked man...
Excuse me?
This naked man. My mother's lover. He was in the attic, Ariel. He said, "What you looking at, Ricky?" And he disappeared. And I shot you. It was a mistake. And you were all bloody and dead. And I took you. And I put you in a 4-foot hole. So, dirt and blisters, okay?
Okay.
Yeah.
Yo, I'm gonna score me a bag of Doritos. Y'all straight? Yeah, all right.
Code 2, intersection of 12th and Grant.
We have visual confirmation on the suspect. Hit it.
All possible units, please respond.
Unit 1, William Ford, requesting a 1141 at the intersection.
And his booty, that was like, position
A! All units,
what the fuck is this?
Copy that, it's 1049.
What's going on, officers?
Yarn store down the road was just held up by a young black male fitting your friend's description.
Huh? What are you talking about? It wasn't me.
No, not you.
No.
Hey, Frank, you see any other young black males here in Lakeshore Bluff?
Don't see any.
What?
In the car, darky.
But I'm not black. I'm white. My whole family's white. My dad's Irish. My mom's Norwegian. We go to the 4th Avenue Lutheran Church where I help with the bake sale every Sunday.
Settle down back there, chocolate.
Now, Poochie, I know things could be better between us. I'm gonna make things better. When we get home, the first thing I'm gonna do is chain your ass to the bathroom sink. Beat on you till I get tired. How's that sound, huh? From now on, you're gonna eat your dinner out of a little freaking pie tin like the sorry ass dog that you are.
What are we doing?
We're getting up a posse and go after him.
Well, what posse are you with?
Your posse.
We ain't no posse.
Well, how about you? You a posse?
I ain't no posse.
You a posse?
I ain't no posse.
Anyone around here a posse?
I ain't no posse.
What do we do now?
We find a posse.
Find a posse?
Good idea.
Don't be stealing my terminology.
What say we branch off of here and look around?
Good idea.
Look around for a posse?
Reckon there's one around here someplace.
Reckon there's no use beating a dead horse to death.
You listening to me? Do you have any idea just how powerful this man is?
So?
Don't be so naive.
What?
You and I live in the real world.
What is that supposed to mean?
That is supposed to mean that you and I both know that men like Wakefield always get away with murder.
Maybe you're a goddamn vampire.